And with my voice partially recovered, we are back after an exciting first race. There was too much going on that I couldn't keep an eye on everybody. So, Ben Windcharger, what were your thoughts on that race?
Well, you can definitely tell that these drivers want to do well tonight, and they're just going to be constantly, as you saw, going to be constantly fighting over these positions, whether that's for first position or that's for the last position. There's going to be fights.
Alright, so the replay is ready to go on my end. Just waiting on you two.
Still loading up a little bit.
Okay, and by the looks of things, we're going to be doing a reverse starting grid, so this will be great for Jabberwockies, as he will be in second, and also for King Cobra, who will be leading.
Still trying to find it here.
Okay.
As we've seen in the past, though, if King Cobra can get a little space behind, or a little space between him and the guys behind him, he's gonna take off and just kind of run away with the win. But since we don't have results, because I can't find them for some reason on the tour site, we're not exactly sure how this is all gonna go out.
Any predictions from you, Windcharger, as your replay is loading up?
Expect more of the same for race two. I mean, especially with the reverse grid, it's going to be even closer. And there's going to potentially be a lot more contact. This track naturally is very, very, I'm going to say, oversteery. So cars are going to be sliding around. Although I think with front wheel drive, I think it kind of gives it more a little bit more understeer because the track doesn't have much grip in it.
Guys,
What's up?
do you see two cobalts on this grid?
Well, there are 13 cars on the grid.
How many were there in
Where
race
did
one?
Camber King come from?
He probably missed the first race.
Okay.
Right, so that means Camber King is going to be up in first, which means they might have to
Nope.
readjust the grid.
Nope, because if you miss race one, you start in the back
Okay.
for race two.
Yeah.
All right,
As I'm
so
still loading in.
that's
It's
okay.
taking forever tonight. I don't know why.
Your internet,
Eh,
boy.
forced servers.
Well, it didn't take too long for me to load up. Okay, so we got King Cobra and Camber Kings, both Cobalts. This might actually benefit, maybe.
Two cobalts is better than one.
Well, you know what's better than one Kia?
Three Kias?
No
No
Kias.
Kia. Oh, yeah.
Yes!
All right, I have loaded in.
Okay. How about you, Ben? Still need more time?
I'm good. I'm loaded. Let's go.
Okay, with the magic click of the image checkbox, counting down in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Alrighty, so we have Camber King coming in last minute, which means he's gonna have to magically go into the back as he comes to a slowing. Well, he comes to a slow start here. Alright, it looks like they're gonna do a warm-up lap this time. I think.
Yeah, they pretty much have to where Camber King came in.
Alright,
So we're
folks.
getting a little close to the back of Camper King there for a second.
Alright, so without further ado, let's take a look at the starting grid for race two. Alright, so we're looking at a Honda Zed Sock combination here. We got Jabberwockies and Slider in first and second place. In row two is King Cobra, the first of the Kobolds. And next to him will be Saga of Ries. Hopefully, we'll see more of him. In row three, I got it right this time, Connor7195 of Team Hard. And next to him will be Player Asleep in the Seab. Row four will be the beginning of the HCR train, Belmont and TJ Steele. In row five is Mystic. Alongside him will be Solar. In row six is Plow Tubby and the winner, HCR Hamish. However, in the last row will be Camber King 52. That can concludes your awesome drift style super happy fun time show at Indianapolis Grand Prix Circuit.
The things you have to do to warm up your tires in front wheel drive cars.
It provides a great show for everyone.
Yep.
Okay, and
I'm sure tire companies love it.
Alright, sorry, it took a little bit for it to get back up to front, so right now I'm at a minute and 43 seconds. As Jabberwocky says, just
blow the
sword. Whoops.
Did you go into the future again?
Because, probably.
Alright, because Jabberwocky just went 88 miles an hour over the start-finish line, so he needs to back up. Really, really back up. There he goes.
There you go. Good boy. Good boy.
And one of the Chevy Cobalts has magically appeared.
Ta-da!
Also, I like how the crowd has vanished. Where is the crowd?
What the?
They got tired for us waiting for us to not have real life commitments so we could do the race commentary, so they all went home.
This is great for the pit crew because this gives them stretching room.
Yeah. Can I just say, I just want to comment on Connor's car. If you hadn't noticed it yet,
ready to go at the rear of the field.
Oh my gosh.
I will take a look at it really quick. Is there something I need to see on Connor's car?
Well, how about the lack of primary colors and the abundance of colors that can be just described as neon?
Anyways, green flag is out, and Jabberwocky begins the race at Lobby... Race 2, Lobby A. I can't speak. Anyways.
Close enough.
Battle for second place between Saga of Reese, King Cobra, and Salado. And a bigger battle in the middle of the field. Woo!
That didn't sound good. What happened?
Second, third, and fourth place almost did a ballet through turn one. And update.
And Saga, it was a Kia sandwich between the two different Hondas.
Well, speaking of bright neon colors, Connor has now jumped up, well, was in fourth, has now dropped down to last.
Yeah, Connor went a little wide coming out of turn five and put his car into the grass, so he lost a lot of time right there.
Actually, speaking of grass, a lot happened from 10th to 8th. As we see the HDR cars trying not to cause a wreck. Those Mazdas. So we have Hamish and Solar currently in the back.
Oh! Trouble! Oh, man, I don't know how he saved it.
What happened?
The Jabberwockies almost got turned by... he got turned by Saga of Reese coming through the kink, and Saga is dropping down through the field.
I think you mean Plow Tubby, because...
No, Jabberwocky's is coming.
No, that was Jabber.
That was Jabber? How did...
Yeah.
Because space magic. Meanwhile, in second place...
Okay.
Second place is King Cobra, so... Chevy Cobalt power. And of course, there is a train. I kid you not, there is a train of cars from third back. And a bigger cluster in the middle. I'm seeing three wide going on here. This is crazy. Going onto the rear bumper cam of Connor 7195. Oh my god. I just saw it. Oh my god, there goes that Mazda. Oh my god, there goes the Mazda.
Oh! More contact. Player asleep ran wide. Almost caused a major drama.
Major drama.
And the middle of the pack has shuffled again. It looks like Connor has now moved up into 8th place. And Hamish is currently in 7th, with Mystic right in tow on the inside line coming through the turn.
I think I'm behind you guys.
Currently at 5 minutes and 40 seconds.
Okay. So am I, and I'm still trying to figure out. Jabberwocky's is in first. So who got turned around?
That was Jabberwocky's. He almost got turned around.
I missed it completely. Never mind.
Well, he did.
As you were.
He did get... he got turned completely sideways, but at one point coming through the kink that they just went through. Yeah, it was... At least I think it was... It, when I looked through the running order, it said it was Jabber, so... Oh, is. Hamish had a little moment through NASCAR Turn 1.
Care to elaborate, Windcharger?
Probably Pan got a little bit too close to the sticky, probably, and had to hit the brakes in order to, or let off the gas in order to not hit the sticky.
And almost a collision between the Saab and the two Mazdas. Coming out of Turn 3, going into Turn 4. I have to give credit to Player Asleep in the Saab. He's doing a good job. So far,
just trying to keep up all the action going on here, for goodness sakes.
I better not cry. Yeah, there's definitely...
Now is not the time to go up and get a snack, folks.
No, there's just so much going on that it's hard for me to try to keep up with the front.
And here, I'll watch the front, you two try to keep up with the traffic.
Right now I'm focusing on Slider and Connor and Player Asleep right now. Although it looks like one of the Kias has slowed down, that would be TJ Steele. I think he made contact with somebody. And a battle for position between Slider and Connor coming up through NASCAR Turn 1. Slider is going to hold the inside line, and Connor is going to try to make the pass on the outside line. However, Slider cuts off Connor.
Oh, wow. Hamish had another moment through NASCAR Turn 1, and Solar had to take a minor evasive action, and he came so close to pounding the wall coming out of the final corner.
Definitely caught some of that. And Connor has slowed down Slider and both of the Mazdas. So it's getting pretty dicey up here for 7th place. Side by side with Slider, Connor, Hamish, and Solar. And Connor makes the pass and successfully moves up into his respective spot, which will be 7th place.
I don't know who that was. Slider came down and chopped Solar's nose off.
And Connor went wide. Managed to get safely back on the track. And Hamish and Solar have caught up to Connor on the third to last turn. So those Mazdas have made clear of both Player Asleep and Slider.
Now, I'd watch it through here, starting now, because this is where Hamish has had his problems last couple laps, is through NASCAR Turn 1.
And it looks like Connor's going to get a bump draft off of one of the Mazdas going through NASCAR Turn 1, almost making contact! Nice save! That was freaking amazing. However, one of the slower Kias is now in the way.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting.
Whoa! Contact between the Mazdas!
Oh my gosh.
Brilliant move by Connor to keep Solar behind that Kia and use the Kia as a pick. But I don't think he's going to have any choice but to let Solar go now.
Solar has now moved up into 7th place, and Hamish is going to follow in suit as well. So both of the HCR teammates are pushing that one lonely team hard are out of the way. So I guess you could say we have a Team Hard filling sandwich as Slider has mysteriously come out of nowhere with Player Asleep in tow. Where the hell did they come from?
Every race car driver's dream. Just wait for the battle to ignite in front and just slowly reel them back in.
Well, it didn't look too good for Player Asleep. It looked like he got pushed off by Slider.
Well, while all this excitement is going on, somehow Poatsubi has managed to get in front of King Cobra. I completely missed that. And is actually starting to catch up to his teammate a little bit.
Nice. Meanwhile, Connor still has HCR stuck up in his grill, coming back onto the speedway section. And it looks like Connor's going to try to hold the outside line. And Hamish is going to try to pass on the inside line. Coming down onto the front straightaway, it looks like Hamish is going to get the position away from Connor, just barely.
Coming out of turn one, King Cobra is going to have to try to fight off both Belmont and Mystic as they come in turn one. Mystic's got the inside line. He's going to push wrong car. He's going to push King Cobra out and just take third position away.
Just a quick update for Connor on back. It looked like Player Sleep tried to get through Hamish. That did not work, as he is now still on the side of Connor, and Slider is also caught up in the mix as well. So Player Sleep almost gained a position and then had to give it back.
As Hamish is finally clear of Connor. I think Connor's holding these guys up.
Well, Connor and those other two were three wide. He had to go off the track to avoid spinning both of them out, from what it looked like. However, they're still almost three wide. Now switch down to two. So Connor is currently in 10th place, Slider's moved up into 9th, and Player Asleep is currently in 11th place. And we are down to one more lap in just a moment.
Yep, just like the lap before, we had a HCR.
However, Connor and Slider are now battling it out on NASCAR Turn 1, coming down onto the front straightaway. We are on the last lap, and still, we're seeing action in the back of the field. Unfortunately, we're going to have to cut away from them and check out the front. And as you point out, Jabberwockies and Plow Tubby are currently in 1st and 2nd place.
Back and forth in 5th, Belmont just got around King Cobra at turn 1 and was able to push King Cobra back into 5th place. Now where Solar is going to be probably, maybe another lap or two would actually catch up with him, but since the last lap, I think Cobra's safe, relatively, in 5th position.
And Cloud Tubby and HCR Mystic slightly went off track, off the road.
I'm still keeping an eye on this battle with Connor, Player Asleep, and Slider, and Player Asleep just showed Connor the bumper. And Connor locked the brakes up going into the next turn, and he's going to allow them both by.
And it looks like both the Honda Zeds are trying to keep that one lowly HCR in third place. Unless Plow Tubby decides to slingshot ahead of Jabberwockies to claim the win. Coming down towards NASCAR Turn 1, it's going to be Honda Zed, 1st and 2nd place. Checker flag will be waving, and the winner of Race 2 Lobby A is going to go to Jabberwockies with Plow Tubby in 2nd and Mystic in 3rd place. 4th will go to Belmont, and King Cobra is going to take home 5th.
Is it good? Okay, no.
Oh! Slider just barely beat Connor to the line.
And we just caught the trail end of that, folks. All right, we will be right back for the epic conclusion of Lobby A and then the other lobby.